And welcome to part 3 of the USS Voyager build. last I left off, we installed the airlocks. Now, for some stupid reason, I don't know why, I did say that I needed to recess these, and I haven't done that. So, I'm going to take the X-Acto, peel off the airlocks again, and then using a sharp pencil, put it back into position and then just draw around the airlock. And then if I drill out the inside line of that, that'll give me my placement. And then we should be able to put that into position. Just checking there whether or not it was going to interfere with that lip. But I think we're all good. It'll go through there. I think we have a nav light as well that roughly goes somewhere in this general area as well. So I'm going to have to peel all these off very carefully. Get the pencil line drawn around, get them drilled out, get them placed, and then we'll be moving on to the sensor bands, which we have one here, which I think is that one. Yep. So we'll go around and we'll get all them sorted. So yeah, I'll be back as soon as I've got some further progress. See you in a bit. Okay, so we've got a bit further now. All the airlocks are being recessed into position. It's taken quite a while to get this done because, of course, I was cutting one of these out, test fitting it, and bing, it flew off, and it took me 40 minutes to try and find the airlock because I even went on eBay to order a new set of footwedge just for an airlock. And as I was doing that, the sunlight just picked up a hint of metal, and I thought, oh, and luckily I found it. It was in the most unlikeliest of places. But anyway, I got that sorted. All I need to do now is take some tulip and just put some just on the back edge so we don't get any light leak through there. But yeah, that's the airlocks done. Then I think I'll probably just take some styrene and just neaten up these edges a bit, and then obviously box it in as well at the same time. So that's them. Now, I slept on it last night about the sensor arrays around the dish. Now I do have some styrene, which isn't a million miles out. So if we just pull that into position there, it's just about the right size to keep that. So if I keep this bit here, enlarge these, because that is the same size as the sensor cluster that goes in there, which is no good. So if I do take it back just to that point there on both sides, I can run then a piece of styrene straight across that and bridge the gap. Now, I think what would be best, because of the thickness of this sensor cluster here, if I do it that way, it's still not going to be recessed. So I think it's going to take two strips of this to cut them out, place the sensor band in like that, then cut another piece with a hole in at the back, so then it's further back, it's two rows back basically, then it'll be nicely recessed into position, and then take a third piece on the back side to seal that in. I think that's probably the best way of doing it, because I do have a thinner piece of styrene as well, which, if fingers crossed, this little lip here, this is where the bottom saucer fits onto. So if I do, in fact, you know what, yeah, it probably will, it'll do that. So that'll create the lip going around there, so the saucer, I'll have something to sit on. Which causes another issue. If I do that, then when it comes to putting this bottom saucer on, these little lip bits here are no good, because they're designed to fit right underneath that to sandwich the whole thing together, and we don't need them anymore. So I'll have to take my needle files, file that down, sandpaper it following the curve, and that should solve that. So yeah, I'm gonna go off, do some tulip on the ship, let that dry, and then get around to the sensor bands at last. So we'll be right back. Alright guys, welcome back. I'll try and make this segment quick because the neighbours are cutting the grass and they're making a lot of noise. What we've got at the moment is this. I know I said I was going to build some boxes, but to be honest, all day yesterday I was trying to build boxes for these and it kind of looked bad. It was awful. So what I've gone ahead and done is taken that double styrene and followed this line through, because when the bottom saucer, it sits on this little lip, so it will sit on that styrene no problem. And then what I've done is I've glued that, the greeble, on the back side of that, and then the little piece of stock that I have, I've run over and I've made it just a little bit bigger than what it needs to be, because I need to sand that flush with the hull. And to get the rounds in there, I'll use Vallejo filler, and I'll just have an experiment on this side, because this side you're not really going to see because it's going to be next to a mountain. So I'm going to experiment with this, sand it all down as soon as this glue's set up, and have a go with the filler and see how well that turns out. I've also made it a little bit longer than it needs to be because I need to sand that flush. And then hopefully with the bottom saucer, once that's in position, we just need to get rid of those tabs then. And then that should sit flush with that. That's the plan anyway. I tried to do it Richard's way, where he built the boxes, but to be honest, I mean, all day yesterday I was trying to build one and it just looked like crap, basically. So I'm going to sand this flush, sand the bottom, and then I'm going to have a go with some filler. Then I might mask this section off and just prime it just to see what it looks like. It should work, I think, with the Vallejo, because it's got the small applicator that I can get into these little gaps. And then afterwards I'll just put some black tulip in there to make sure there's no light leaks through it. But that's as far as I've got with that. I still need to do the other side, but this way it's a lot quicker. What was I going to show you? Post came, look how tiny these are compared to... I'll just see if I can get them out, and then... compared to the other washers that I have, these are microscopic. So we've got 1.3mm all the way to 0.7mm, so I'll be able to use that for the anti-collision lights and the smaller ones for the nav lights. So that's good, we're good to go with that, and that is really fast delivery. I wasn't expecting this for until next week or even the week after, so pretty good. And when you always find stock like this, it goes out of... Like, I got it from this place here, and it says they're running out of units and they don't know whether it's going to be continued or not. I should have really got a few more of these, because be useful in scratch building. But yeah, that's about as far as I've got so far. I'm going to go crack on, get the other side done, and we'll be right back with that. Catch you in a bit. So we've got it all finished now, pretty much. The sensor bands are all being sanded, they're nice and smooth now, all the way around. It's a bit messy there, but that'll get cleaned up. Same here, and we've also got the port side done as well. So all the sensor bands are in place, and I've added in my filler as well now at the sides. I'm going to give that plenty of time to dry up, and then I can go in with my little drill bit and try and carve out the rounds. It might need another layer of filler on that, because it looks like it's dimpled in a bit, but it's not a problem. Yeah, they've all seemed to have done that actually, so I'll just get some more filler, and in fact I'll do it now. But yeah, I'm just using the Vallejo putty. With the applicator it's really easy, so we'll just add a little bit just in there, and then to get it flush, just straight down like that. But I might just leave it a bit, leave a bit more than what I actually need, and then I can sand it. But yeah, there's just a lot of cleaning up to do on this, and then, but like I said, I'm not going to rush this part. I'm not making sure everything's filled in just yet, because that'll get done once the bottom half is put into position. At the moment I'm just making sure that I'm covering my bases. That should do. Get rid of that. So yeah, it's looking a bit of a mess at the moment because there's bits everywhere, but it's getting there. I want to leave it like maybe about 12 hours really, just to make sure it's solid. Although, what's weird, in this country at the moment, it's hotter than Miami. So, which is fantastic, because stuff is drying really quick. So you don't have to wait around long before. I mean, this is already starting to set up already. So I might be able to get it done maybe today, but like I said, I don't want to rush, because that's when you end up screwing up. And this build has gone so quick so far that I don't want to jinx it. But yeah, definitely a lot of sanding is going to be needed on this, I think. The way it is at the moment. Fingerprints and all sorts in it. But that should do it, I think. I'll leave it like that, I think, and let all that set up. And then I'm going to go around and just take a micro drill bit and just shape the edges ever so slightly, and that should be enough to replicate it. But yeah, it's looking good. This is the side that you're going to see more than the other, so it doesn't really matter so much about this one, so we'll test this side first, like, just to make sure everything's okay. But yeah, everything's good. Enjoying it. Haven't fallen out with it yet. But yeah, these little greebles are a pain in the backside. These ones here. I still don't think it's 100% straight. But I think it's alright. I'm not going to lose sleep over that bit. The other thing that I do need to be getting on with, I think, now is sorting out the bottom saucer section. Just mask off these bits here and then just sand just the little lips off. I can do that with a sanding stick. It'll only take about 10 minutes probably to knock that down. So that's no biggie. And then after that, literally all we've got to do is scribe in this line here. Obviously the windows need installing, but I need to get some material. I've ordered all my window lighting and stuff, so that should be here hopefully soon. And what else? I'm sure there's something else, but oh, lifeboats. We need to put the hatches on there. And I think that's the saucer pretty much done. And my battery's about to die on me as well. So I've just stuck some primer down on this, and just to have a quick look, and I think it might actually work out. There's a lot of cleaning up to do, and I've gone a bit too far with the Dremel there, but apart from that, the general shapes are getting there. It's just going to require a lot of cleaning up, I think. But yeah, it looks like it's going to work out, so I'm just going to go clean up these areas a bit more, probably throw down some more primer on them, and just take it from there. So yeah, we'll be back with that. Alright guys, So about 3 or 4 days has passed since we did work on the sensor bands. And, you know, basically what it is I'm sort of suffering at the moment, same as Carwin. Us British folk, we're not used to this weather, and it's been fantastic. The past week it's been like 31 degrees, and we're just not used to it, you know? And to be honest, I was getting so hot, sweaty and tired that I was making stupid mistakes, and I'll just go get the saucer section here. What actually happened was I was getting really, really tired and fed up, and I needed to sand the inside edge of the dish here, because what I'm trying to do is match up the lower saucer with the upper saucer. So we've sanded this nice and smooth now, and instead of taking material out of this section to fit the greebles, I was trying to do it the opposite way for some reason, and I got the Dremel out. So what does that do? It heats the plastic, it warps the plastic, melts the plastic, and that's exactly what happened. So the starboard side here, this piece just basically came off, and I had to just walk away, and I left it, because, you know, you start fighting with it then and going, oh, and you get sick and tired, and you're gluing it, and you just make a mess. So I've had about 4 days off since the last segment, but I'm ready to get back on it as soon as possible. So my plan is I'm going to take out some material on the lower saucer, because at the moment it's not a million miles away. You know, it's very, very little that I need to actually take out. But I had to have that break because it was just doing me head in. But yeah, I feel your pain, Carwin, on that one. So yeah, let's get back to it. Enough rambling, let's crack on. So, getting back to this saucer. The pain of my life. You can see there, look, we've got a bit of tulip in there, just to light block it. That's been glued, it's going to require sanding. But you know what, instead of messing about with this, what I'm going to do is leave this for now. Get on with the rest of the detail. We've still got lifeboat hatches to add to there. We've still got this line to scribe in. But I do want to match up the lower section just so that job is done, because all the LED lighting has been ordered now. So there's only a little bit of material, as you know, just from the greeble side, but instead of taking them out from that, I'm just going to be sanding this down, basically. Either way, even if I hadn't done the modifications with the sensor bands, there's still a ton of filler with this, because this just sits on the underside, so you've got like a big seam that needs to be filled anyway. So I'm not really adding any work to that, because it's a job that would have to be done anyway. But yeah, I want to get on. What do I want to get on with? I want to get on with my seam. I want to get on with hatches. I've got obviously the window frames to do. I've run out of clear styrene, so I need to take a trip to the shop. But my idea behind that one is to take some painter's tape like this, lay the windows down, draw around that to cut out my masks. Then I'm going to back the windows onto this. Then I'm going to apply the masks and then glue it into position. That way it's done, don't need to worry about it. Before I prime any of this, I'm going to get the whole ship together in one piece, then prime it. I think there's no point like doing a nice painting job on this, because you've got like seam lines running this way, all the spine, because I've heard that the spine is a terrible affair, because there's just light leaks that comes through this. But yeah, I've got my little washers ready. These look really cool, these. I was a bit worried that it was a bit too small, but I think, you know, one of them, yes, it's going to be small, but I think it'll work. I'll definitely be able to get a fibre optic in the centre, and it should give us our little ring. So we need to sort that out at some point as well. But yeah, just pure frustration the past couple of days, and you know, I didn't want to make a mess, and that's what would have happened. So, you know, just have a little break, have a think about it, and then come back and attack it. And that's what I'm planning to do today. I just need to let that tulip dry up before I start trying to match it all up, otherwise tulip's going to be everywhere. So we'll be back as soon as I've got further progress on that, guys, so catch you in a bit. Well, it's not pretty, but finally got the lower saucer in position, so there's quite a lot of filling to do, which, you know, is normal, but everything's aligned, so that's great. I can now move on now, I don't have to worry about that now. yeah, I think I found some little clear styrene that I've got for the windows, so I think I'm going to go ahead and use that, I think. But yeah, that's the saucer sorted. So the only thing to do now is to get all the other details put into position and tackle this little scribe light to put in there, and job's a good one. So yeah, I'll be back as soon as I've got some further progress, so catch you in a bit. So I've just installed these lifeboat hatches. Now, depending on what reference I use, you can just see them in the corner there. They're a lot further along on that one. But then if you look at the studio model here, you can just make them out that they're not actually that far up the spine. Just literally like the corner, and that's sort of what I've emulated there. I don't, you know, it looks okay. So I've matched them up. So I'm going to let the white glue just set up in this heat. It probably won't take that long. So, but yeah, that's the lifeboat hatches in position. I'm just going to let that set up, and then we can move on. I think what I'm going to try and tackle as well is putting that scribe in. I've put it off long enough. But first of all, I'm going to let this dry up, and then we'll be back, and I'll see if I can get that scribe line put into position. So I think what I'm going to do now is actually put in the bottom windows. Now, it's already got its styrene on, and I've also masked off that window, so that's good to go. As soon as that's glued into position, I don't need to worry about that. That's ready for primer. I'm just going to make sure that these windows are clean of flash before, which I'll test fit them before. But it's just an easier way of doing it. Just put the mask in now. Saves you doing it later. So yeah, we'll be right back as soon as I've got these windows installed. And we're back. The windows have all been installed. They've all got the masks in position. And what I've done is I've gone round with tulip. The front one was a bit of a challenge, but that one's nicely in now as well. So yeah, that's good. If we head over to this saucer here, the top saucer, we've got windows. They're all masked as well. And I've also gone in and boxed in the airlock as well. And, I don't know where you can see it, but we've got a little scribe line put into position as well. Find out exactly what that looks like once I get some primer down on it. But yeah, all the side windows airlocks are done. You've seen the lifeboat hatches there in position. The only ones I haven't done yet are deck 2 and deck 3, because I still have to figure out if I'm using an SMD or fibre optic for the spotlight. Probably SMD, but that needs to be drilled out on that yet. So I just wanted to get all the little side windows in, and they're all masked and ready to go. I also need to do the little pillars, but I'm waiting for this glue to set up. Then I'm going to go in with some tulip just around the frame, so we don't have any unwanted light leaks from them. And I think that'll do it. I think we're running about 20 minutes at the moment on this one. So all I'm basically going to do now is tulip the top saucer. Get that all nice, neat and tidy. And I think, yeah, we'll be back in update 4, is it? Is this update 3? Can't remember. So I'll catch you in a bit. See you later.